So hello all of you and welcome to this new session on the request of many of the students. What is my secrets? Let's see the Dr. Cheshta's secrets today. So everybody always ask, ma'am, you got All India Rank 261. So what was the thing you did? How did you study? What were your notes? Which online coaching you followed, which offline coaching you followed. These are some of the very, very commonly asked questions whenever I go anywhere to teach. So today I thought of sharing my secret stash with all of you. So what is the secret stash which I have, which I feel that helped me a lot for cracking the NEET PG entrance examination with the amazing rank of 261. Starting with the first important stash or the secret is time management. I always make sure that I give proper time to everything in the life. For example, nowadays there are many students who ask me, ma'am, we have a compulsory duties, we have to go for duties, whether you are doing the internship or final years or post interns, you have to go to the duties. So what? We also used to go. I have joined as a medical officer and I used to go to the hospitals, but still I can score All India Rank 261. The only thing which is required is proper time management. Now, what do you mean by proper time management? You have to divide the time. For example, if you wake up in the morning at 7 o'clock, you reach your hospital by 8 or 9 p.m. after a breakfast, then you stay in the hospital till 1 p.m. Please do not read at that time. Just go to the hospital, do your daily duties, come back at 1 p.m., have your lunch, and if you have a habit of sleeping, then sleep for half an hour to 1 hour. After that, you have to start reading. If you start at 4 p.m., make sure that you will read at least for 3 to 4 hours non-stop. You can have some snack in between if you are feeling hungry again. You can have some cup of tea with you again if you want. But there should be a 4 hours of study. So if you have started at 4 p.m., you have to study by 8 p.m. At 8 p.m., take a break. At 8 p.m., you can have a break. You can either talk to your family members, you can go at the terrace, you can go outside in the garden, wherever required, whatever is safe. I'm not saying that you have to go out during this pandemic time, but whatever it feel like, whatever give you a positive thing, just do that. 8 to 9 or maybe 10, you can take a 1 hour or 2 hour ka gap, have your break, have your dinner, come back and again start reading from 10 p.m. to 12 p.m. So look at me, look at this thing. Every day from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. and from 10 p.m. to 12 p.m. Every day you have 6 hours, which is sufficient. Trust me, these are sufficient periods for your preparation. So please make a proper time management, make a proper time schedules. Everything is important. And there are many students who tell us that, ma'am, we do not take bath because it is a wastage of time. But that is not true. Your body hygiene is also very important. It gives you a very positive reinforcement to your brain. You'll feel a lot of positive energy if you take your bath. Okay, so please try to follow a proper time management. Do not waste time. Do not feel that if you are going for your hospitals or your duties, that is wastage of time. No, 6 hours every day is sufficient. See, if you are not doing any duties, then also in one day, the fruitful time is only 6 to 8 hours, not more than that. So if you are getting a 6 hours of study every day, nothing more than that is required. Okay? So the first key or my first secret is I used to have a proper time management. You know what I used to do? I used to attend the hospitals in the morning. I used to have my breakfast. I used to sleep after that. And then I used to study non-stop till 2 p.m. in the night. Because I am a person who reads more at night. I used to wake up late in the morning. So whatever suits you, because somebody have a habit of waking early, somebody have a habit of reading up till the late nights. So whatever suits you, please try to do that. The first thing which I'll say is time management. Okay, second thing, smart study. What do you mean by this smart study? See, everyone have sufficient material with them. they will have sufficient material, whether it is XYZ notes, whether it is ABC book, whether it is this online platform, that online platform. Everybody will have sufficient note. But it doesn't mean that everybody will get selected. It is only those who do the smart study. What do you mean by smart study? You have to look yourself with the help of the previous year MCQs. Just go through all the subjects and look that which is important topic, what is important subject which is getting asked again and again. Try to focus more only on those subjects. You don't have to read everything. If you read from A to Z, it's not possible or not practical to remember everything. So please read smartly. Try to do only those points which has been asked repeatedly in your entrance examination. Now I'll tell you what I used to do. When I used to study, there were no online coaching. So we don't have any mobile apps and all. We used to go to the online coaching centers and they used to give us study material. Now what I used to do, I used to take that study material, I used to see the section where the MCQs were given and the explanation of the MCQs were given. Now what they used to do, they used to put a small cue on those important points which has been asked frequently in the entrance examination, and I used to write those small cue wala points in a separate notebook. So what this did, if there is 100 page notes, I used to get 20 most important points or 50 most important words from those 100 pages. And what I used to do in the end, I used to revise them properly, because it is very difficult to revise all the pages, all the subjects in the last 2 to 3 days. But it is very easy to revise the short 20, 30, 50 pages books which I used to make when I was preparing for my exam. So remember that it is the smart study. It is not how much you study, but it is how efficiently you study. That is the second of my secret which helped me score better than others, better than my colleagues. So second point is smart studies. Third, the same thing which I have told you, make the short notes. It is impossible to revise all the 19 subjects 2 days, 3 days before your entrance examination. But if you club them together, if you make the short notes which contain only the important point, you can revise them twice, thrice, whatever time. And I myself have done this, so please trust me, this is nothing impractical. If I can do, everybody can do. So please make short notes. So this is a part of smart study only, because it is not that how much you have read. You have a whole 3 years of your MD MS when you become expert of that subject, but now it is important to get through this exam, and for passing this exam you need little bit of extra brain to study smartly. Okay, coming to the fourth point, leisure is very, very important. See, any machine, if you keep start or if you make that machine working throughout the day, throughout the week, throughout the month, throughout the year, in the end it will stop working. So you have to give rest to anything, whether it is a machine or it is your body. So leisure is important. If you have seen that routine which I have made, I have told you that if you are doing a duty from 10 to 1, at least give a 2 hour break here, then read from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m. again give 2 hour break here, then read from 10 p.m. to 12 p.m. whatever suits you. You can even extend to 1 p.m. or 2 p.m. but the leisure time is very, very important. If you will not give leisure, whatever you have read, you will just forget that. So leisure can be anything. You can help your mom cooking, because see, now it's corona time, you cannot go out and play. You have to do something inside the house. So you can help your mother to cook. You can read something other than the, you can read some comics, some novels, whatever you feel like. You can dance, a very good leisure activity. You can play with your brother, sister, your siblings, even your family. And if you do not have any personal swimming pools, which usually not everyone have, but yes, you can take a bath, you can use some leisure activity to maintain the self hygiene. So please give time to leisure also, because this is very, very important. Okay, last point, revision. I have told you previously also, exams is all about revision. If you read a lot, subject 1, subject 2, subject 3, subject 4, subject 19. What happens? Everything is like a, what do you say, like a bharta, like a mixed vegetable inside your brain. But you don't want a mixed vegetable. You want something which should be very, very effective and practicable, for which can help you answer your exams. So please write, revise, repeat. The number of time you'll revise a topic, you revise a subject, better will be your performance. Do not make a mixed vegetable. You have to make a clear-cut single thing which helps you crack your entrance examination. So revision is the key point for any exam, whether it is INICT, FMG, NEET, PG or ABCD exams. Lastly, one very important, which is my personal experience, which I want to share with all of you, is keep calm and stay relaxed on the day of your exam. I've seen a lot of students who keep on reading, you know, like till they go to the examination hall, they keep on reading. They bring so many books to the exam center also. But that is something which you do very stupid. You cannot read anything there. It's just that it's you feel like, okay, I take many books, then it's a better, you know, others will think that I'm preparing better. But that will create stress to you. More relaxed you are, better will be your performance. Trust me, 2 days from my entrance examination, I've stopped reading. In my entrance, when I went to my exam center, only I was the one who was not studying. And see, I got 261 rank because I was so patient during my exam. I have read all the questions very patiently and I can use all my brain because it is all fresh. I've taken a good sleep, 8 hours of sleep, everything was fine. And then I went and gave my entrance examination. So please remember, keep calm and stay relaxed. That is something which is a very important mantra to get yourself into your exam with a good rank. So please keep calm and stay relaxed. So that is all about the Dr. Cheshta's secret stash or topper secret stash. About me, I am Dr. Cheshta Agarwal. I am a faculty who teaches NEET PG with the experience of 5 years. I have also co-authored a book that is The Pigmentary Disorders. I am famous for my teaching style, the rank, as well as many of my academic achievements. That I received the best original article, All India 2018. Now you can reach me on the Unacademy platform. If you want to take subscription, please use this referral code. Now currently we are going on with an amazing discount that if you use my referral code Dr. Cheshta YT, you can get a 3-month subscription with 1 month of extra absolutely free. Similarly, if you go for iconic subscription which give you an access to Unacademy and PlebLadder, using the referral code Dr. Cheshta YT will give you amazing discounts. The 92,000 has been reduced to 58,000, 77,000 has been reduced to 49,000, and so on. So please subscribe to Unacademy using the referral code. Do not waste time, and I'm here only to help you out. So please follow me on my profile and let's crack it together. Bye bye.